Thank you, Mr. Speaker. You know, the first line of this is called the Mark A. Crisafulli Economic Development Act. Now, nothing against Mr. Crisafulli. I've heard he's a nice guy. I've heard he's ill. I wish him well. I don't know why we're naming this bill after a guy who's a spokesperson for Twin River. This is the same guy that said a no-bid deal was a terrible idea and spent months railing against it, and now we're going to name the bill after him. But it kind of segues into my point I got into earlier about Twin River and its influence. I'm glad Representative Slater brought up some of the history. In 2012, May 24, 2012 specifically, the bill was introduced to add table games at Twin River. And I don't think the dispute was about table games. It was about the deal, the cost, the money, just like it is here. And at that time, according to Twin River's own figures, 70% of the table game take, the projected take, was going to go to costs and expenses. That left 30% profit. And the question was, where would it go? And the deal that was presented back then was 18% to the state, which has now gotten lower over the years, and 12% for Twin River. And at the time, at that finance hearing, it was introduced on May 24, which was the Thursday before Memorial Day. The hearing was scheduled for May 29, the Tuesday after Memorial Day. And I was at that hearing, and no one from Twin River came to explain those numbers or where they came from. This was different administration, different leadership here, all different people, but the same thing. There's a deal presented, we can't get straight answers as to why 20%, why 18, why 20, why not 25 or 15? No one can answer that. The fiscal staff in the House was forced to present the deal. And nothing against them, but they were just presenting the numbers. You couldn't get a straight answer as to why it was going to be 18% for the state and 12 for Twin River. Couldn't get an answer at the committee. So I went to the floor on June 12, 2012, and I put an amendment in just trying to change the 18% to 20. And no one in that whole debate could answer why it was 18. No one could answer. So fast forward, it passed, obviously the amendment failed. On a party line vote, Deputy Speaker Lehman did vote for it. I appreciate that. So fast forward to 2013, the next January, I put in separate legislation to do the same thing. It was a bipartisan bill. It was co-sponsored by a future majority whip and a future Speaker of the House, actually. It was a great bill. And it went before the House Finance Committee 3 months later at 1 o'clock in the afternoon on a Wednesday. And the bill, all it would have done was change the percentage. It would have cost Twin River $2 million in literal profit per year and put it into the state coffers. You would think Twin River would come and oppose that, but they didn't do that. No. They had two guys, a lobbyist and one of their internal people, stand in the back of the Finance Committee room. They didn't even bother to submit written testimony in opposition or explain why they should be allowed to keep $2 million. It could have gone for any number of state projects. No one testified. The arrogance of that organization is incredible to me. I remember looking over at the lobbyist, who I'm not going to name because I like him personally, but I looked over at him and I welcomed him and said, do you want to testify in this? And he kind of smiled and nodded his head because they knew that we don't matter. All they had to do at that time was go up to the third floor. That's all they had to do. I don't know if things have changed, I hope they have, but they didn't care what we thought, because they knew that whatever deal they negotiated, we would just go, sure, it's okay. Representative Place hit the nail on the head. They work for us. I don't like the fact that we're essentially in the gambling business as a state, but we are. And we have to accept that fact. And the fact that we are, we should extract as much profit for our taxpayers and our citizens out of that deal as we can. And I know Twin River is not going to close up shop and walk away if we increase our take and decrease their profit. Let's be serious here. We could have, the amount of money we've left on the table because of deals made by people that would never explain who they were, what the numbers were, is incredible to me. And we're doing it again, and it's worse. And the fact that when this original proposal came out, Twin River complained and whined and went public and screamed and yelled about a no-bid deal, and now the guy's got his name on the legislation? What are we, fools?
1 minute, please.
It's amazing to me that anybody is okay with this process. It's incredible. What are we doing? Vote this down, and let's put this out to bid. That's the proper way to handle this. Thank you.